Good morning, viewers. It's a new day. Welcome to today's devotion with Open Heaven Daily Devotional Study, a channel that brings you the Open Heaven Devotional of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. Invite your family and friends. Get your Bible and your Open Heaven Devotional, even as we read along today. God bless you.
Today's date, Saturday, March 18th, 2023. Topic: The Word Guides, Part 1. Memory Verse, 2 Timothy 3 verse 16. All Scripture is given by inspiration of God, and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. Bible reading is taken from Psalm 119 verse 97 to 105. Oh, how I love thy law! It is my meditation all the day. Thou through thy commandments hast made me wiser than mine enemies, for they are ever with me. I have more understanding than all my teachers, for thy testimonies are my meditation. I understand more than the ancients, because I keep thy precepts. I have refrained my feet from every evil way, that I might keep thy word. I have not departed from thy judgments, for thou hast taught me. How sweet are thy words unto my taste! Yea, sweeter than honey to my mouth. Through thy precepts I get understanding, therefore I hate every false way. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet, and a light unto my path. Our topic again is The Word Guides, Part 1. Message. In 1 Kings 17 verse 2-16, God sent his word to guide Elijah to where he would get food for a period of time. When the time elapsed, the word came again, telling him to go to Zarephath where God had already made arrangements for his feeding through a widow. The word of God guides. He tells you what to do when there seems to be no way out of a difficult situation. I pray that the Lord will open your ears so that you can begin to hear from him. You will solve problems faster if you can hear directly from God. When I was working on my PhD thesis, I ended up with many simultaneous equations. Even solving one of these is stressful enough, talk less of the volume I had to deal with. I tried and tried to solve them, but I couldn't. One day, before going to bed, I read Exodus 14 where the Israelites crossed the Red Sea. Suddenly, I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Bring your equations." I did just that, and then he began to say, "Put this one on the right, put this one on the left," and so on. By the time I finished and took a look at those on the right, they all had something in common. It was the same thing for those on the left. Because they were all jumbled together before, I couldn't see that. The Lord then said, "Solve the ones on the left separately, then combine." That was exactly what happened at the Red Sea. The sea parted, the Israelites passed through, and the sea came together again, killing Pharaoh and his army. 5 hours later, my thesis was taken to the external examiner. He read through and said, "Award this boy his PhD, I have no question for him." He was told that there must be an oral examination, but he insisted that he had no questions for me. He had no questions because I wasn't the one who solved that problem, it was the Word of God himself who did. If you allow the Word of God to be your guide for every decision you make, you will never walk in darkness, and he will guide you to the fulfillment of his purpose for your life, John 8 verse 12. Action point. Make God's word your guide in all decisions you make. Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, I pray you guide me to the fulfillment of my destiny on earth in Jesus' name. Amen. Bible in 1 year, Judges 14-16. Our hymn today is hymn 10. In Christ alone. Have a great day. See you tomorrow. God bless you.